In this section, I will illustrate the procedure of elastic analysis that we have seen in the previous section with the help of two examples done using the ANSI software on actual problems. The first case study consists of a nozzle to shell junction in the 2D domain. So we are considering a vessel of the dimensions as shown in this particular figure, and we are interested in performing stress analysis or design by analysis check for the upper part of this vessel. So we want to check whether the nozzle assembly and the head to shell assembly, these components are safe against the design. The materials used for the various components, the design pressure, the design temperature, corrosion allowance and other details are given in the figure. And in case it is not visible in the video, you can look into the handouts where they will be clear. The details of the nozzle are given in the figure shown. Kindly note that the portion of nozzle beyond the flange, that is the cover and the attached nozzle to that, is not covered in the analysis. Only the portion till the flange is covered in this particular analysis. Also note that there are many intricate geometric details available at various points. Typically, in the design by analysis approach, you do not take each and every minute detail of the geometry. You do some kind of approximation in order to simplify the geometry so that the finite element mesh which is created is not very complex and unnecessarily computationally dense. The first step in the ANSYS is to define the project. Once you are done that, you will define the material data. As we have seen, the essential properties that one would require is the Young's modulus and the Poisson's ratio, which needs to be defined. Next, you have to prepare the geometry. Please note that the entire vessel is not modeled here. So after the nozzle to shell junction, you are considering certain length of shell. So this length of shell is considered of certain distance so that when you are applying the boundary conditions at the free end of this shell, it doesn't influence the stresses at the head to shell junction. So this length is typically considered as 2.5 times under root RT, where R is the radius of shell and T is the thickness of shell. You need to set the geometry as axisymmetric in ANSYS. You have to apply the load and boundary conditions. The displacement boundary conditions are applied at the bottom end, where it is fixed only in UY direction, and the X direction, that is the radial direction, it is free to expand. You are applying internal pressure on the entire internal surface of the vessel, and at the top surface of the flange, you are putting an equivalent pressure which is calculated based on the total axial pressure thrust which is acting till the gasket geometry, till the gasket diameter of the nozzle. Once you have applied boundary conditions, the first thing to be checked is to see that you have applied the boundary conditions and loads are in proper direction. So this is evidenced by expansion of the shell. In many cases, if the direction of pressure is wrong, you will find that instead of expansion, you will find that the shell will compress or collapse inside. So that should not happen. So this deformation check gives you idea about the correctness of your boundary conditions and loading. Also, the values of deformation, it gives you idea as to your units are proper. Next, you review the one axis stresses in order to identify the locations of your interest where the stress classification lines need to be drawn. So as shown here, we will find that there are three regions where the stress analysis would give you more severe stress results, and they need to be analyzed further. In order to define the stress classification lines, you have to define the path in the ANSYS terminology. So for example, if one, when one is defining the stress classification line across the point P to Q, you have to define a path in the ANSYS from point P to point Q. It is followed by the definition of the parameters for stress classification along this particular line. Once the stress classification line is defined, you can obtain the classification of stresses across this path for each of the stress components. So you'll find a summary table which will give you the values of stresses at along the stress classification line. So you'll find the membrane stresses and membrane plus bending stresses across this path. Once one has obtained the induced stresses and done the stress classification, one need to check against the allowable stress. So allowable stresses, the primary allowable stresses are obtained from the design code, and they are checked against the allowable as defined in the hopper diagram. So you need to check the induced local membrane stress against what is allowable and so on. In this case, in across stress classification line 1, the requirements of plastic collapse check are satisfied. Similar checks you need to do for the other stress classification lines. In case study 2, we see a 3D analysis. So in this case, we are analyzing a cylindrical shell to nozzle junction for the acceptability of the stresses. Along the similar lines, you will have to define the material data in terms of the Young's modulus and Poisson's ratio. Define the geometry, which is in this case is three-dimensional. You have to do mesh discretization. In this case, the choice of element size is important as it will determine the computational time. The FE mesh needs to be uniform, especially in the region which you are interested in. So since we are interested in nozzle to shell junction, the mesh size in this region is critical and needs to be chosen properly. The boundary conditions are applied. So in this case, we are considering half the cylinder to limit the size of model. So the symmetry faces have been given the symmetry boundary conditions. The internal pressure is applied on appropriate surface, and the pressure thrust is applied on the free surface of the nozzle. After checking that the deformations are proper, one would check for the von Mises stresses, and we can see here that this particular location is having the highest von Mises stresses. So that is where the stress classification line needs to be drawn and further analysis needs to be done. This is the view from the other side. So again, the locations for stress classification line are can be inferred from this observation. You need to take section of your model in order to get the region where you want to draw the stress classification line. As shown here, this is the point 1 and 2 define the start and end point of the path across which stress linearization would be done. In the similar fashion, you will obtain the results from ANSYS stress analysis program for the stress classification line which is drawn. And the obtained results need to be compared with the allowable stresses using the hopper diagram check. And the same procedure need to be followed for the different stress classification lines at the other regions of discontinuity. So this illustrates the way design by analysis approach is applied to check the first criteria of ASME check, that is a plastic collapse check at the various regions of interest.